We wanted you to feel like an 8-year-old had made it.
And we were hoping that people come out of it and they're inspired to make stuff of their own, build things and try new things and go out of their comfort zone. And that was sort of the inspiration for the movie from the beginning.
That was the dream, that somehow you would go to this movie thinking, okay, it's fun, maybe it's cynical, but you would come out going, wow, they told a real story, and I really cared, and it was like emotional, because we thought, this movie's gonna be so crazy. You're gonna go to 7 different worlds, there's gonna be a million characters, there better be something that you can like follow and hang your heart on so that you can just like stay awake the whole time. So hopefully, I don't know if there were a lot of people asleep at the end of the screening, but hopefully everybody stayed awake.
Yeah, it's pretty loud.
Yeah, so. We also made sure that it was really loud.
We wrote in the script that there was a song called "Everything Is Awesome," which is supposed to be the most infectiously cheesy pop song. That it was sort of making fun of the thing that it actually is. And it crawls into your brain and it never leaves.
It's a dream come true for a writer and a director, you know. That's half the battle, is like hiring people that are that funny and that good. Then, you know, you can hide behind them and then your weaknesses as a director or writer will be concealed.
And we wanted to sort of mix it with like sort of people who aren't known for comedy but we thought might be really funny, like Morgan Freeman and Liam Neeson, and then a bunch of people who we knew were really funny and great improvisers like Will Ferrell and Chris Pratt and Elizabeth Banks and Will Arnett and the whole rest of everybody, with Nick Offerman and Alison Brie and Charlie Day and all of them. And we were really open with everybody and loose and wanted to make sure that everyone was comfortable improvising and everyone did an amazing job of making it feel real and feel natural and be really, really funny. It helps when you get super talented people.
Well, you know, we wanted it to embrace the limitations of the Lego bricks, but then to take it to a scale that you couldn't accomplish in anything except for a huge Hollywood movie. So, we made choices like they're not gonna be able to do more than this with their arms, and we're gonna use that as an expressive tool. And it mostly worked. We were pleasantly surprised that gambit paid off, I think.
And we were really insistent that everything in the movie be made out of Lego, because you'd never seen something like that before. The oceans and fire and smoke and explosions and clouds, everything. And people thought we were kind of crazy. Like, I don't know if that's gonna work, but we were deluded enough to think that it would. And it turned out awesome, I think.
Yeah.